Number 21. Etiquettes and virtues of reciting the Qur'an. Allah Ta'ala says in the Qur'an, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرَجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورُ لِيُوَفِّيَهُمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Indeed, those who recite the Book of Allah and establish the Salah and spend of what we have provided them secretly and publicly can expect a Prophet that will never perish, that he may give them in full their rewards and increase for them of his bounty. Indeed, he is forgiving and appreciative. He is appreciative of the one who recites the Qur'an. Hadith number 23 of 40. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reported to have said, Allah Ta'ala listens more attentively to a man with a beautiful voice who recites the Qur'an out loud than the master of a singing girl listens to his slave. The simile could be in our modern times, the way people listen to these singers and how much enjoyment they get from the songs that they're listening to with no equivalence and no resemblance. But Allah Ta'ala listens more attentively to a man reciting the Qur'an loudly than these people who listen to their songs. So the bearer of the Qur'an should seek to beautify his voice the best he can. And the one listening to him is Allah Ta'ala himself. And you cannot have a greater audience than having the audience of Allah Ta'ala. Hadith number 24 of 40. Bara reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, beautify the Qur'an with your voices, for indeed the nice voice increases the beauty of the Qur'an. Hadith number 25 of 40. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reported to have said, the one who is proficient with the Qur'an is associated with the noble, obedient scribes, i.e. the angels. And the one who falters and finds it difficult, for him is double reward. The one who recites the Qur'an proficiently, and that's what we should seek, the bearer of the Qur'an should seek to be. He is like one of the malaika, one of the angels. The one who falters and finds it difficult, for him will be double reward. He gets double reward for struggling with the Qur'an. That's the honor of the Qur'an. Hadith number 26 of 40. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the one who does not recite the Qur'an in a melodious manner is not from us. Hadith number 27 of 40. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reported to have said, the house in which the Qur'an is recited is seen by the inhabitants of the heavens like the people on earth see the stars. Subhanallah, the house in which the Qur'an is being recited. People above see them like we see stars. The Qur'an is nur, in our hearts are nur, and the malaika surrounding them are nur. And that nur is multiplied by these factors. Hadith number 28 of 40, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked about who had the best recitation. He said, when you hear his recitation, you can see that he fears Allah Ta'ala. Supplementary Hadith A. Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam say, whoever recites a letter from the Book of Allah, then he receives the reward from it and the reward of 10 the like of it. I do not say that Alif Lam Mim is a letter, but Alif is a letter, Lam is a letter, Mim is a letter. The reward of just reciting one letter of the Qur'an is multiplied by 10. Supplementary Hadith B. Uqba bin Amir radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the one who recites the Qur'an loudly is like the one who gives charity openly, and the one who recites the Qur'an silently is like the one who gives charity in secret. Supplementary Hadith C. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is reported to have said, the parable of the believer who recites the Qur'an is that of a sweet citrus fruit. Its fragrance is nice and its taste is nice. The parable of the believer who does not recite the Qur'an is that of a date. It has no smell, but its taste is sweet. The parable of the hypocrite, the munafiq, who does not recite the Qur'an is like that of a bitter desert fruit. That's the example of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is giving. Its smell, is bitter and his taste is bitter. Supplementary hadith D, that Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam explained the following ayat of the Qur'an, that recite the Qur'an at dawn, verily the recitation of the Qur'an at dawn is ever witnessed. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam explained that it is witnessed by the angels of the night and the day, because that is the time when they are both present. That is an optimum time to be reciting the Qur'an. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told Abdullah bin Amr, recite the Qur'an in a month. Abdullah bin Amr says, but I have the power to do more. Then Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, then finish the recitation of the Qur'an in 7 days and do not finish it in less than this period. Supplementary hadith F, Amr bin As radiallahu anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, envy, hasad, is not justified but in the case of two people only. One who, having given the Qur'an by Allah, recites it during the night and day, and a man who, having been given wealth by Allah, spends it night and day. Supplementary hadith G, Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu reports that during the last 10 nights of Ramadan, whilst in i'tikaf, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when someone is in salah, then they are in deep conversation with their Lord Almighty, so you should see if anyone is engaged in this deep conversation with their Lord, and do not make your voices loud one over the other in your recitation of the Qur'an. And this is a point when the bearer of the Qur'an is reciting the Qur'an at home, in the masjid, at other locations, you should be wary about who is around you and if you are unnecessarily disturbing others. Yes, the bearer of the Qur'an should have the Qur'an with him all the time, but we do not want to cause any difficulty upon others.